Another volcanic eruption in Iceland is now almost certain to occur sometime this month. In a worst-case scenario, this could begin within the town of Grindavik. Whether the associated Reykjanes volcano erupts today, tomorrow, next week, or sometime later is uncertain, but if it does continue on its current path, an eruption is almost all but assured. Since Reykjanes' last eruption ended on January 15th, molten rock has been refilling its underlying magma chamber at a rate of approximately 5 cubic meters per second. As of February 6th, this has totaled 9.5 million cubic meters of material, which is only 500,000 cubic meters less and 2 million cubic meters less than the volumes which triggered Reykjanes' last two eruptions. While we only have a small sample size to compare to, if the prior figures represent the lower and upper bounds of what triggers a so-called magma run event, then such an event and likely an eruption is expected to occur sometime between February 7th and February 11th. Of course, this is not a figure set in stone, as an eruption could occur later this month or might not even occur at all. Volcanoes are, simply put, quite unpredictable, even for complexes such as Reykjanes, which is essentially a cluster of straight lines. Luckily, a new methodology is being utilized to give an extra 30 to 240 minutes of warning for if and when another magma run occurs. What I am referring to is the fact that before each of the last two eruptions, a specific borehole of the Svartsengi geothermal power plant experienced notable increases in both temperature and pressure that would ordinarily not occur. These warning signs appeared between 1/2 and 4 hours before an eruption commenced on the surface. Additionally, by looking at the readings of other boreholes, stronger variations to the south indicated the movement of magma in that direction, while the opposite is true when magma erupted further north. While still in its early stages, if the relevant borehole known as borehole 12 detects elevated pressure and temperatures, a computer will automatically send emails to relevant authority figures and disaster management agencies, which then will likely put out their own alerts and warning texts. You might be wondering why such a system is being utilized at all, as a system that sometimes gives more than 4 hours of warning beforehand is simply to wait for a strong southward trending earthquake storm to begin along the known underground 15-kilometer magma dike. The answer is twofold. Not only can some eruptions begin without a strong swarm of earthquakes, but every single magma run in the lead-up to it has involved 1/2 or less the number of average daily earthquakes the prior cycle contained. This is due to the fact that the crust has already been sufficiently strained and deformed since October of 2023 near Svartsengi in the magma dike region that stresses which had built up over the last 700 years have largely been released. We may thus reach a point where so few earthquakes occur that it can no longer be utilized as a reliable method to signify ongoing magma movement. Here is the current hazard map from the Reykjanes volcano, where the most likely location for an eruption to occur is northeast of and not within the town of Grindavik. While the next eruption, if one were to happen, is most likely to occur within the region currently shaded in red, it could theoretically occur within any of the shaded regions, perhaps slightly beyond them too. I want to note that if and when the next magma run event begins, that the longer it occurs for, the further south the relevant magma is likely moving. In other words, a longer duration magma run with an intense earthquake swarm is very negative, as it indicates an increasing likelihood of lava erupting into Grindavik directly. Since any eruption is likely to erupt no more than 20 million cubic meters of lava, lava wall barriers are likely to once again be fairly effective. A second lava barrier is thus currently under construction to contain any future lava flows that breached a section of the January 2024 eruption lava barrier. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.